The majority of us in this room today most likely already have or will contribute to one of the leading problems facing the world today, and that is the growing population and how we're going to feed that population. And as animal scientists, we're actually positioned in a very unique environment as we work with livestock that don't directly compete with humans for a food source. That is, you and I won't go out to a pasture and eat grass for 80 to 100% of our lives. And as animal scientists, if we're going to continue to feed the world, we must live by the motto of one calf per cow per year. And not only that we have one calf per cow per year, but that calf grows into a healthy and viable food source for human consumption. And believe it or not, that actually begins back at the beginning of pregnancy. And if we were to take a group of cows and breed them once, we would find that approximately 90% of them would actually conceive. But by day 50 of their gestation, only half of those cows would have maintained a viable pregnancy. And the majority of the time, this is actually due to failed nutrient transport and nutrient availability for that fetus to use to grow. And if I were to ask you, well, how does a fetus receive its nutrients during pregnancy? The vast majority of people in this room would say through a shared blood supply between the maternal and fetal systems through the umbilical cord. And while that answer is correct for late gestation, actually in early gestation there is no umbilical cord, and the fetus has to receive its nutrients through transporters in the uterus and developing placenta. So what our lab did was we developed a way to study early nutrition to the developing fetus. And some of the things that we found was that these transporters in the uterus and developing placenta are actually expressed at different time points during early gestation. They're actually located in different tissues throughout the uterus and the placenta and at different abundances in those tissues. And the nutrients that they transport are actually found in different concentrations and made available to the fetus differentially throughout different days of gestation. Additionally, if we reduce the intake of those cows to about half of what they were supposed to be getting, we actually reduce the concentrations of some of these nutrients being made available to the fetus. So how do we actually apply this? Well, now we're able to take this data and we're able to start to test to see if we supply certain nutrients at specific time points during gestation, then hopefully we're able to increase the viability of that conceptus to maintain our motto of one calf per cow per year so that we can continue to feed the growing population. Thank you.